Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Welcome. Today we're gonna talk about another fairy tale while you see me drawing in the background. These drawings are a little bit different. I got as feedback that it would be fun to have like multiple drawings for a fairy tale so you can kind of follow the story. So I tried that for once. Please tell me if you like it and if I should do more of kind of these formats. Drawings. Today we're gonna discuss the fairy tale Vrouw Holle, or the English translation for it is Mother Holle. It's a grim fairy tale and I will be reading it from the book The Complete First Editions, the original folk and fairy tales of the Brothers Grimm. These are a translation of the fairy tales of the Brothers Grimm when they were written in their first edition, which was written in 1812. So yeah, let's get right into the story, and after that we will discuss the history a bit and where Vrouw Holle or Mother Holle came from. A widow had two daughters, one who was beautiful and diligent, the other ugly and lazy. But she was fonder of the ugly and lazy one, and the other had to do all the work and was just like Cinderella in the house. Now, one day the beautiful maiden went out to fetch water, and as she went over to pull the bucket from the well, she leaned over too much and fell into the water. And when she awoke and came to her senses, she was lying on the ground in a beautiful meadow, where the sun was shining and thousands of flowers were growing. She left the meadow, and soon she came to a baker's oven, full of bread. But the bread was yelling, "Oh, take me out, or else I'll burn. I've already been baked long enough." So she went to the oven and diligently took out everything. After that, she moved on and came to a tree full of apples. "Oh, shake me," the tree exclaimed. "My apples are all ripe." So she shook the tree until the apples fell like raindrops, and she kept shaking until they had all fallen to the ground. After that, she moved on. At last, she came to a small cottage, where an old woman was looking out of the window. She had such big teeth that the maiden was scared and wanted to run away. But the old woman cried after her, "Don't be afraid, my dear child. Stay with me, and if you do all the housework properly, everything will turn out well for you. You must only make my bed nicely and give it a good shaking so the feathers fly. Then it will snow on earth, for I am Mother Holle." Since the old woman had spoken so kindly to her, the maiden agreed to enter her service. She took care of everything to the old woman's satisfaction and always shook the bed so hard that the feathers flew about like snowflakes. In return, the woman treated her well. She never said an unkind word to the maiden, and she gave her roasted and boiled meat every day. After the maiden had spent a long time with Mother Holle, her heart saddened. Even though everything was 1,000 times better there than at home, she was still yearning to return. At last, she said to Mother Holle, "I've got a tremendous longing to return home, and even though everything is wonderful here, I can't stay any longer." "You're right," Mother Holle responded, "and since you've served me so well, I myself shall bring you up there again." She took the maiden by hand and led her to her large gate. When it was opened and the maiden was standing beneath the gateway, an enormous shower of gold came pouring down, and all the gold stuck to her so that she became completely covered with it. "I want you to have this, because you are so delicate," said Mother Holle. Thereupon the gate closed and the maiden found herself upon earth. Then she went to her mother, and since she was covered with so much gold, her mother gave her a warm welcome. Then when her mother heard how she obtained so much wealth, she wanted her other ugly and lazy daughter to have the same good fortune. Therefore, this daughter also jumped down the well. Like her sister, she awoke in a beautiful meadow and walked along the path. When she came to the oven, the bread cried out again. Oh, take me out. Take me out, or else I'll burn. I've already been baked long enough. But the lazy maiden answered, do you think I want to get myself dirty? She moved on, and soon she came to the apple tree that cried out, oh, shake me, my apples are all ripe. However, the lazy maiden replied, are you serious? One of the apples could fall and hit me on my head. When she came to Mother Holle's cottage, she wasn't afraid because she already heard about the old woman's big teeth, and she hired herself out right away. On the first day, she made an effort to work hard and obey Mother Holle when the old woman told her what to do, for the thought of gold was on her mind. On the second day, she started loathing, and on the third day, she loathed even more. Indeed, she didn't want to get out of bed in the morning, and she did a poor job of making Vrouw Holle's bed. She certainly didn't shake it hard enough to make the feathers fly. Soon, Mother Holle became tired of this and discharged the maiden from her service. The lazy maiden was quite happy to go, and now expected a shower of gold. Mother Holle led her to the gate, but as the maiden was standing beneath the gateway, a big kettle of pitch came pouring down upon her instead of gold. That's the reward for your services, Mother Holle said, and closed the gate. The lady went home covered with pitch, and it stuck to her for as long as she lived. So that's our story for today. Mother Holle was quite well known in Hessen, which is where the brothers grew up. So well known that they used to say that Mother Holle was making her bed whenever it snowed. You can say she was kinda like Thor, but with snow instead of lightning, and she was old, and instead of a hammer, she shook a pillow. But still, quite badass. So Marvel, there's your next superhero. The brothers cite Henriette Dorothea Wald as the source for this version of the story, but in their notes they speak of a few other retellings. However, this one is the most well known, at least in the Germanic countries where I live, and is still the one that is told to children here today. There is the question of who Mother Holle is. It's very much implied that she's something magical, since the bread and the trees in her world are also something magical. In another version, one that was cited by the Brothers Grimm, Mother Holle is called a Nixie, which is a water nymph. And the well that serves as the entrance into her world still suggests that in the story of the brothers. But there's also a theory, you can call it a fairy tale theory, that sees the same as the goddess Hulda, who was an old Germanic nature goddess. What she was the goddess of isn't really clear. Some say she was comparable to the goddess Diana of the Roman mythology, but others say she was the goddess of sky or birth and death. But there's one thing that all these stories have in common, and that's her connection with water. I don't think the Brothers Grimm wanted her to be portrayed as a goddess, and in their notes there isn't any mention of it at all. Even the other stories they cite don't even mention it. And that's probably because of the rise of Christianity that really erased the old gods and goddesses of the nature religions. So the story wasn't meant to worship any goddess or allude to her as a goddess, but to meant to display that being kind and helpful and hardworking is rewarding. And likewise that being lazy also has its reward, but that it's not a reward that you want. Thank you so much for keeping with me in a story and to explore it together with me. I've known the story for quite a long time. It was something that I heard in my childhood, and I never really heard about the goddess Hulda, so it was really interesting to find that out, that there was a goddess that was connected to Vrouw Holle. And because you stick to me to the end, I'm gonna tell you a little fun fact. In a Dutch theme park, the Efteling, which is fairy tale themed, there's a little cottage in its forest. Yeah, the theme park has a forest, if you know, then you know. And that cottage is in like the area that has the Vrouw Holle theme. And so it's Vrouw Holle's cottage. And that cottage used to be just a normal cottage of a family that the family lived in. So that's really, I thought it was funny. So that's a little fun fact for sticking with me to the end. Thank you again for watching. Thank you, Robin, for staying quiet during the recording of this video. I hope you have a great day. Comment down below if you already knew this story and what story I should talk about next. Bye!